During the season, they have not seen the defense of the nature of these Lady Beavers, only averaging 33 points a game.
They have not, but you know, on the flip side of that, the Lady Beavers have not seen the height that they are seeing with Leighton Christian.
So as a key to a game?
Key to the game, they've got to box out, they've got to get some boards, they've got to eliminate putback opportunities, and you know, they've got to get the ball at the floor quick to so they don't have to go up against the big girls for the easy shot off the glass.
Kylie Goodwin, the senior, and where's number 24? She stands about 6'4", 6'5". She's a McDonald's All-American, we hear. And so we're ready for the tip-off. It's sponsored by Delta City. Take a look at Delta City for rock climbing, golf courses, and a whole lot more. It's going to go out of bounds. I think they'll jump it again. No, it'll go to the Lady Beavers off of Goodwin. And the Lady Beavers will start with the ball. Appreciate Delta City and our tip-off of tonight's basketball game. The Beavers with the ball. Jaquoi Christian on it with the left side. Goodwin covering in the middle. Carter now for the Beavers to Gale, top of the key. Just underway here at Sevier Valley Center. Quakerson, right wing. And Soaring Eagles play a zone off defense. So the Beavers will move into their zone offense. Gale inside to Yardy. Yard turns and faces. Inside to Jones on the left side. Goes up, blocked away. And I believe that was blocked by number, I have to take a look at that number when she clears, 15. And we don't even know who 15 is.
Oh, dear.
So we'll have to get that for you. It's Jada Wims, actually, wearing number 15. So for Goodwin from the free throw line, up no good. And Wims will pick up her first personal foul.
And what happened right there was Cindy Dillon just got very good position and made her go over the back. So that'll be a first foul on Wims.
Full court press by the Lady Eagles. On the right side to Jillens. Just underway here at the Sevier Valley Center. Quarterfinal action. And we'll try to keep you posted. We've got all kinds of great stuff coming up. Christensen on the right side to Gale. Gale on the right wing. Back to Carter, to Gale. And the Lady Eagles now in a kind of a 1-2-2 matchup zone. And it's going to be taken away. Jaquoi Christian from behind, chasing down Danielle Thomas. Her shot up, no good. But she gets the offensive rebound. Gets it in the middle. Back up top, the key to Wims. Now a three-point shot coming for Leighton Christian, up no good. Rebound going to be taken by Sydney Jillens. Foul to number 12, Whitney Lusk.
A lot of action, and you can see Leighton Christian is very aggressive, and they're going after every loose ball. Fortunately for the Lady Beavers, they picked up the foul on Lusk.
So now it'll be the Lady Beavers basketball. Still no score, 6:31 left in the first. Carter with the ball. She's covered by Danielle Thomas. Thomas herds Carter over to Yardley, now to Jillens on the right side. Back to Carter. Carter dribbles in, fakes a three over to Christensen. And Christensen will set back up top of the key. So a zone defense against the Beavers to Jillens. Jillens on the left side, ball's knocked away, picked up though by Christensen. Now knocked away again, Wims with it ahead of the pack. Carter is going to go ahead. Oh, they'll call a foul on Britland Carter. It'll be the first on the Lady Beavers.
You know, Jada Wims, she is super quick. That is her second steal of the game. It's her hands all over the ball and causing a lot of frustration for the Lady Beavers.
So number 22, Tess Henry, will throw the ball in for Leighton Christian inside to Wims. Wims turns, fires, shot up, no good. Rebound to Abby Yardley. Back over to Christian. Christian ahead of the pack to Gale. Gale on the right wing, kicks back to Christian to Carter. Carter steps up, takes a three. Back to Christensen. And it's pressure by Thomas. Christian with the left hand dribble to the wing, top of the key to Gale. Gale back to Christensen. 5:42 left, still no score here from the Sevier Valley Center. Gale will drive in, 8-foot jumper, it's up, no good. Rebound can be taken off of the Beavers. It will go to Leighton Christian.
Very, you know, it's really uncharacteristic. You know, almost 3 minutes into the game and still no score. Both teams getting opportunities but not being able to capitalize on them.
Oh, now full court press goes off of Leighton Christian and it'll stay for the Lady Beavers. Nice steal, Jaquoi Christensen there. With the stop. Might have been Tavy Gale. Who was it?
I don't know.
Yeah, it was Christensen knocks it off of Leighton Christensen. Carter on the right side knocked away again. Leighton Christian getting into the passing lanes, and the Lady Beavers are going to have to be a little more careful with their passes with this Leighton Christian team.
They've got to step to the ball. These girls are not going to let them get any pass, easily.
On the right side, Carter to Gale to Christensen. Corner, there's Jillens. 12-foot jumper's hard, no good. Rebound going to be knocked out of bounds off of Gale. Goes to the Eagles. 5:17 left in the first quarter. Going to be Henry. We'll throw in full court press to Thomas. Back to Henry. In the middle to Goodwin. Now to Thomas. Ahead of the pack. 12 goes in. Kind of loses the ball. It's going to be up. Knocked away. Taken bound by, well, it's going to be a pass to Goodwin. Shot up. No good. Rebound going to be finally off of the Lady Beavers to Leighton Christian. And the size and the defensive speed bothering the Lady Beavers early on.
It is. You have Gail Yardley and Christensen all underneath, just unable to pull down a rebound.
So the Henry will throw in on the right side to Goodwin. Goodwin on the baseline. Covered by Yardley. Takes a shot from the baseline. No good. Rebound to Jacoy Christensen. 5 minutes left in the first quarter. Still no score. And it's going to be Gail from Christensen. Drives in to Yardley on the baseline. Yardley in a triple team, and she will be fouled, I believe, by Goodwin.
Yeah, she was quickly collapsed on by three players, and Kylie Goodwin will pick up her first foul of the game.
And the captain, Chaos, comes in off the Beaver bench. Lindley White in. And still no score. 4:43 left in the first. On the left side, it's Jillens. Jillens at the free throw line. Covered by Lusk. Back Gale, right side. Shot no good. Rebound, though, to Sydney Jillens. And Jillens is going to dribble out of the action. Back to Gale. Now the ball's going to be knocked away again. And Jacoy Christian will have it, and John Marshall calls a timeout. Fish Lake Lumber timeout. We'll take it and be back after this.
Since 1947, Barney Trucking in Salina has built a reputation of unparalleled customer service and satisfaction in the trucking industry. Barney Trucking in Salina is now hiring local drivers. If you're looking for a solid career in the trucking industry that has a positive working environment, join the Big Blue Trucks of Barney Trucking. The job includes benefits, training, retirement, and requires a Class A CDL license and an endorsement for doubles and triples. To apply, go to BarneyTrucking.com or call 529-4422. That's 529-4422.
Taken four. Only nine shots in the game so far. None of them have gone in, so we're scoreless with 4:24 left in this first quarter of play. Beavers have the ball. I think it's a smart Fish Lake Lumber timeout by John Marshall. Remember, Fish Lake Lumber, north of Beaver. You can take care of all your needs, paint center, and more. And now Leighton Christian will have a substitution. Oh, no, the substitution went and sat down. So we're back to live action. So Thomas, covering Christensen. Christensen inside to Yardley. Yardley turns, pivots, shot up, shot no good. And there's another rebound to the Eagles, Henry Tess Henry. Right side, Henry with it. Takes a long three-point jumper up, no good. Rebound can be taken by Goodwin, covered by Yardley. Underneath, wide open layup, shot blocked, though, by Sydney Jillens, or butt in the backboard. And it's going to rebound to Christensen. On the right side to Gale, the Beavers push. Christensen. Covered tightly by Lusk. On the left side now to Jillens. 3:45 left. That's your Eagles Landing score check. Remember, Champs Chicken there at Eagles Landing. And it's going to be Lindley White goes up against Goodwin. Shot no good. Goodwin with the rebound. And the Beavers continue to struggle. Score. Tess Henry back ahead to Taylor. Shot up, and there will be a foul to Jacoy Christensen. Free throws coming for Leighton Christian.
The Lady Beavers, right, you know, they're really struggling offensively because the zone that Leighton Christian is putting on them, they're moving, they're flexing quickly, and inside they're just so tall that they're really struggling, and they've got to make some shots fall or else they're going to be in trouble.
Yeah, the sophomore, Danielle Thomas, shot up, no good, still no score. 3:29 left in the first. Abby Yardley out. Nixon Davis will come in the game. And substitutions continue.
Kaho Usami in for Leighton Christian.
Aha. All right, you saw me in. Shot is up now. A scoreless tie is broken finally at the 3:29 mark. It's Leighton Christian 1-0 over the Beavers. Lindley White with the ball for the Lady Beavers. Crosses the timeline. And it's over to Gale. Gale back to Christensen, top of the key. On the left side to Jillens. Jillens cross-court pass to Gale. Stolen away easily. That's by Wims. Jada Wims crosses over underneath to Thomas. Stolen away by Gale. And then a turnover, as they call it, travel.
And so, in the game for the Lady Beavers, Carly Hollingshead replacing Sydney Jillens.
So some substitutions for both teams. And for the Eagles, it will be Tess Henry. And Henry will look on the baseline for Wims. And it is in, but off of Wims, Henry picks it back up. 3 minutes left in the first still. No score for Beaver. 1 point on the board for Leighton Christian. On the left side is Usami. Inside right, no good. Rebound to Cardi Hollingshead. The Beavers on the run as they push it up the left side. The number's not there. Back to Christensen. Inside to Davis. It'll go off Davis. Turnover on the Lady Beavers as it was tipped. And some careless passing causing problems for the Lady Beavers.
It is, and the Lady Beavers just really trying to find a rhythm right now and not getting into any type of rhythm on either end of the floor.
Yeah, I think there's some nerves.
I would agree with you. Hopefully we can get them out this quarter.
So 2:46 left. Leighton Christian, I think if you're Leighton Christian, things are really the momentum is with the Lady Eagles. They haven't been able to buy a bucket, but right now defensively and rebounds, give me some rebounds on these two.
Rebounding for Leighton Christian, 2 offensive, 3 defensive. Lady Beavers, 1 offensive, 5 defensive. So Lady Beavers actually out-rebounding them by 1.
That surprises me.
But you wouldn't know it.
Now the ball disappeared into the tunnel and they can't find it. So we're trying to find a basketball. And here it comes, the game ball. So that was a little odd.
That was funny.
Basketball disappeared. So 2:46 left in the first. Lady Eagles basketball. And it'll be Henry with it. Henry looking on the baseline. It's almost stolen away by White. And White's going to come up the backside, reach in, kicked away, and it's going to be taken away by Hollingshead, still by Lindley White. Hollingshead picks it up. Gale, top of the key, takes a left-hand dribble over to Hollingshead. Gale back at the point, over to Hollingshead. And the Beavers, you're right, just out of sync so far. The zone bothering Lady Beavers. It's an extended zone. Hollingshead on the right side takes a 12-foot jumper. The Beavers on the board.
It's about time as Carly Hollingshead drives, penetrates basket, and Tavia Gale with a quick steal on the inbounds play.
And then a foul as they foul Gale, and that might be on number 22, Tess Henry. We'll see, and it is. And that's 4 team fouls against Leighton Christian.
And Gale. Oh, I guess Gale took a shot, and they fouled her on the – I didn't see the shot.
I actually didn't see the shot either.
But Gale's going to be shooting free throws.
So Tavia at the line shooting 2. First free throw is up and looks good. And it goes down. The Beavers tie it up. Excuse me, they go up by 2. As Carly Hollingshead stopped the drought at the 2:10 mark was the first bucket of the game. So it's now 3-1. Gale with another free throw coming. Free throws up, looks good as well. And that one's right through the middle. That makes it 4-1. Lady Beavers on top. And Tavia Gale will be replaced by Brilliant Carter. And now Henry. Over to Thomas. Thomas on the right sideline. She goes up, shot, no good. Rebound gonna be taken though by Wims, and it goes in. Jada Wims with the bucket.
You know, and you got to look at the athleticism of Thomas. Wow, she was quick. She went coast to coast and almost got a bucket.
So Lindley White with the Lady Beavers back in. It's going to go up around. Goodwin shot, no good. Rebound on the floor. And it's going to be a foul on Lindley White as she fouls Goodwin.
Captain Chaos, you know, she goes in and she makes things happen on both ends of the floor. She's not afraid. She'll drive to the basket. She's super good defensively. And sometimes she just gets a little excited and picked up a foul.
So Lindley White will cover Henry. So it's over to Thomas. Thomas with the ball, splits the defenders. They'll call a foul. This might be on Lindley White. If so, that'll be number 2. It is. She'll go to the penalty box. And City Gillen's back in the game. You better explain what we mean by penalty box.
Coach John Marshall with his team, if any girl gets 2 fouls in the first half, they are on the bench. And
it doesn't matter who it is.
It does not. And we jokingly refer to it as the penalty box. And people get a kick out of that.
Danielle Thomas with the ball, kicks back out to Henry on the right side to Osami. Long 3-point jump for Osami, no good. Rebound though to Goodwin, and it's gonna be a jump ball. Good job, Nixon Davis, and then Sydney Gillens with the tie-up. Stays Leighton Christian ball.
Leighton Christian, these girls are not afraid to shoot the ball. If they get a good look, you know, not even like an open look, they're taking the baskets, and eventually they're going to start to fall.
So number 12, Whitney Lust back in the game, replacing Thomas as Danielle takes a breather. In the game, Henry. Henry, top of the key to Lusk. Back in the court to Henry. And Leighton Christian covered man-to-man by the Lady Beavers. It's 4-3. Beavers with a 1-point lead, 1:20 left in the first. On the right side, nearly stolen away by Britland Carter, but out of bounds to Leighton Christian.
We've seen the momentum shift a little bit here since Carly Hollingshead was able to nail that basket. The Lady Beavers a little more aggressive on defense.
Henry with the ball, looking for Lusk. And does find Goodwin now. Goodwin turns, pivots on Davis. And now a bump on Davis. And there'll be another foul. So first foul on
Nixon Davis.
And at the minute 14 mark, Abbiardi will come back in the game.
I actually was impressed with how Davis played that. I thought she did very well just going straight up, but you know, girls kind of have a tendency to just kind of shove their chest into the other girl sometimes.
Not a lot of contact there. Lusk with the ball. She goes up, 8-foot jumper, no good. Rebound, fought for, taken by Summit Academy's Lusk.
Wow.
Inside to Goodwin. Goodwin turns, pivots, fires, shot, no good. Rebound off of Yardley to Goodwin. Goodwin goes in. It'll be a foul, I believe, on Carly Hollingshead. And now the Beavers catch up quickly in the foul column.
They do, and what we're seeing offensively here is, you know, Leighton Christian offensively, 6 rebounds, and Lady Beavers cannot grab a defensive rebound, and it's really hurting them.
Now in the penalty, the rest of the half with a minute left in the first, it's 4-3, Beavers 1-point lead. And the foul, steal by Carter. She knocks it, picked up by Yardley. Back to Hollingshead. Hollingshead to Carter, drives in, free throw line, jumpers up, no good. Rebound, though, taken by Abby Yardley, and the Beavers back in business. Carter, top of the key. 45 seconds left. Carter on the right side to Goff. Goff looking inside, now has Jillens at the free throw line. Jillens kicks back to Hollingshead, fakes a three. Cross court pass to Goff. Goff, 3-point jumper right, no good. Rebound though, Abby Yardley for the Lady Beavers. Out to Carter. And Coach John Marshall will say one shot. And they'll do Goff. Goff cross court pass to Hollingshead. Back to Goff. Back to Carter. 13 seconds left in this first quarter. The Beavers with that 1-point lead will take the last shot of the quarter, most likely. Carter with it on the left side to Hollingshead. Hollingshead fakes, goes up, shot at the buzzer, no good. Rebound to, it's going to be to Henry. Henry will dribble out the quarter. It's 4-3, a scoring drought as we take the first quarter. 4-3 Beaver when we come back.
For a full-service pharmacy, gifts, cards, medical equipment, and diabetic supplies, visit Beaver Drug and Gift at 98 North Main in Beaver. Beaver Drug and Gift features a full-service pharmacy, offers a wide variety of medical equipment and diabetic supplies. They're also stocked with a wide variety of items, including gift cards, a wide range of gifts, and treats. Enjoy their friendly service, everyday savings, and expert advice from their knowledgeable pharmacists. That's Beaver Drug and Gift in Beaver. Tired of the hassle of keeping the books of your business? If so, call Majestic Financial Services, a trusted accounting firm that provides payroll, income tax preparation, and bookkeeping services. For businesses or individuals, call 438-7777. For expert advice and service in the real estate sector, there is no one more qualified than broker Gary Brown of Coldwell Banker Advantage Realty in Beaver, who specializes in marketing your property or finding residential, commercial, or recreational properties. Call 438-7777.
Welcome back. Scott Langford, Pepper Gale here from the Sevier Valley Center. And at the end of one, it's 4-3. Let's take a look at field goal percentage. We talked about the importance of defense. We might have understated it.
Without a doubt. Right now, it's pretty sad as Leighton Christian, their field goal percentage is 8%. Lady Beavers coming in a whopping 9%. So neither team shooting well at all.
That's your State Farm Insurance stat check. Stuck in a state of falling behind with kids' financial insurance? Call Brent Stapley, your State Farm agent. Now the Beavers back in, and almost a steal by Leighton Christian. Carter on the right side dribbles in, kicks back to Gale on the baseline. Gale covered quickly by Lusk, back to Carter. Leighton Christian stepping up the defense, short corner to Yardley. Yardley fakes inside, ball's knocked down, taken by Leighton Christian, and Thomas ahead of the pack. She'll going to go up, kind of throw up a shot, no good, and Lusk knocks the rebound away. On the right side, Lusk with it. It wasn't Lusk who actually knocked it away, it was actually Jada Wims. And Thomas back with the ball, top of the key. On the left side to Asami. Back to Henry. And to Lusk. Lusk with the right-hand dribble. Almost stolen by Gale. Go off of the Beavers. On the baseline goes for Leighton Christian.
Leighton Christian coming out this quarter really, really aggressive. And Lady Beavers trying to keep up with it. And, you know, they are getting their hands in the passing lanes and causing a lot of turnovers for the Lady Beavers.
4-3. Beavers with a 1-point lead. Just underway in second quarter action. Not a lot of scoring here. Oh, Lusk drives around. I thought she was fouled twice. No call. And the Lady Beavers, there will be a jump ball called. Stays for Leighton Christian, I believe.
You believe correctly.
The Lady Beavers lucky they didn't pick up a travel, as both Yardley and Jillens had possession of the ball. I think Jillens fouled Yardley.
Well, if you foul your own teammate, then you're all right.
Underneath, it's going to go to Wims. Her shot back up and in. Leighton Christian takes the lead.
Wims is just very aggressive underneath, and, you know, she's going hard to the basket.
So a 2-2-1 half-court press. Carter drives in, kicks back to Gale. Gale inside to Jillen. Jillen's fakes, goes on the left side out to Christensen. Christian fakes a three, now drives in, going to go up for a layup. Shot no good. Rebound, though, Abby Yardley. Shot back up and in.
Ooh, that almost didn't make it, but Abby Yardley took a shooter's bounce and went in.
Now ahead of the pack, Wims, but a little too strong for her, and it goes out of bounds to the Lady Beavers. 6:31 left in this half. 6-5, Beavers on top. It's been a very low-scoring affair. Shooting percentages under 10%. On the right side now, it's Jillens. Jillens and Carter as they play catch. Carter goes across the timeline to Gale. Gale inside to Yardley. Yardley, six-foot jumper. That one's up and in. Abby Yardley scores four in the second quarter.
That's a pretty fadeaway jump shot. Nothing but net. Abby Yardley stepping it up to give the Lady Beavers a three-point lead.
So the senior center for the Beavers taking advantage. While Goodwin's out of the game on the right side, Usami. Top of the key to Henry. Henry fakes a three, drives left hand. Shot up and beautiful with the left hand up and in.
That was pretty. You know, you don't expect to see somebody of her size fake a three-pointer, and she got Yardley there.
Now the pass ahead knocked out of bounds by Wims. And Leighton Christian they're giving the Beavers a dose of their own defensive medicine here.
They are, and I don't know if the Lady Beavers were prepared for how intense and how scrappy the Lady Eagles were going to come out and play.
Yeah, Tess Henry nursing a little bit of a hip problem. Christensen, corner to Gale. Gale, three-point jumper's up and no good. Rebound to Wims. On the right side to Henry, and Leighton Christian moves ahead. Pass on the right side to Thomas. Back up to Lusk. Lusk covered by Carter. Leighton Christian moving the ball. Usami. Back to Lusk. Yeah, that was Henry, actually. Now Tavy Gale with a steal for the Lady Beavers. Ahead of the pack, it's Jillens. Three-on-one break. Gale back. And it goes off of Leighton Christian, and it'll stay for the Lady Beavers.
Lady Beavers getting some good opportunities here. They're just, you know, really struggling to make them count and capitalize on the offensive end.
So another steal for the Lady Beavers. Jillens up, stripped, blocked by Thomas. And it goes to Leighton Christian. On the left side, oh, there's a foul on Abby Yardley. Kind of an easy call. That's foul number two, and that's trouble for the Lady Beavers.
It is. Yardley, you know, she's Yardley with four of the 8 points that Lady Beavers have.
Oh, hang on. That's only her first. That last one, that was correct, was not called on Abby Yardley. I thought they did call
on
Yardley.
No, it was called on Abby Yardley, so that was Yardley's first.
No, that is only first, yeah.
First foul.
I had her down as one in my mind. So it's going to be 1-1 for Leighton Christian, or two, rather. Shot is up. No good. Four Wims. And in Carly Hollingshead replacing Sydney Jillens. So Leighton Christian only one out of three from the free throw line. Wims with another opportunity. This is a shot no good. Rebound to Tavy Gale for the Beavers. And she'll move ahead of the pack. Over to Carter on the left sideline. It's 8-7 Beavers with 5 minutes left in the half. Cross court passers. Hollingshead. Add the bucket. Oh, big foul. No call. Shot up. No good. And now a foul finally called. And she will go to the free throw line. And that means that we go to the Miller County Credit Union free throw line for low interest rates on auto and RV loans. Online banking and coming soon. Mobile banking. Miller County Credit Union. Abby Yardley with a good hustle.
You know, Carly Hollings said there was a lot of contact as she went up. No call. But then Yardley come in with a strong offensive rebound. Was able to pick it up and called again. That's the second foul on number 12, Whitney Lusk, and she's quickly replaced by number 24, Kylie Goodwin.
So Goodwin back in, and Abby Yardley will have another free throw. Biggest thing of the game has been three by the Lady Beavers, and Leighton Christian's led by one on two occasions. Yardley can make the lead two with the free throw, and that one is up and in. So Yardley with the Miller County Credit free throw, and it's going to be Henry with the ball back to Usami, covered by Carter. Usami reverses dribble, now double teamed. But dribbles out of traffic on the left side. Usami to Henry. Henry back to Thomas. Thomas crosses over, drives in. Shot up and beautiful up over Abby Yardley. Danielle Thomas for two.
That was a beautiful play. She just drove into the paint. What the athleticism in that was just phenomenal.
So we're all tied at 9, 4:28 left. Carter goes in, blocked by Goodwin. That one's kind of, and then stolen away by Tavy Gale at the free throw line. Gale goes up, shot up, bounces in and out, gets an offensive rebound, shot back, up and in.
Gale, you know, working really hard defensively and offensively, gets a putback opportunity and makes it count.
Lead goes back to two. Usami with it, covered by Carter. Back to Henry, ahead of the pack to Thomas. Thomas covered by Gale, throws up a shot. Tavy picks up foul, number one, and she goes to the Millard County Credit Union.
No, and Thomas just getting ahead of Gale right there. And, you know, not necessarily a bad foul in that she was going to have a lane to the bucket, but Lady Beavers are in the bonus, so she'll get a free throw opportunity anyway.
Hope you're enjoying tonight's game. It's the Millard County Credit Union for Danielle Thomas. Shot is up and in. She earns another opportunity. And timeout on the floor of Fish Lake Lumber. We'll take it as well. 3:57 left in the half. It's Beaver by one.
Your Carl's Jr. and Beaver and Fillmore not only specializes in delicious charbroiled burgers, they're heavily involved in supporting local area events. The owners and management care about the community and have lent their support to the PTA Walkathon, library reading and local schools programs, the National ATV Jamboree, Swim Fest. They've raised over $11,000 in juvenile diabetes research, and they're currently raising money to support our troops and their Stars for Heroes program. Your local Carl's Jr. and Beaver and Fillmore, not just a local burger joint, a contributor to your community.
11-10, the Beavers with a one-point lead, but Leighton Christian at the line. That's Danielle Thomas. She's already one for one. And Eagles Landing scoreboard, 11-10, Lady Beavers by one. For gas, snacks, and automotive services, and Champs Chicken, visit Eagles Landing on the North Interchange in Beaver. So Danielle Thomas has a chance to tie it back up, and she does. She's 3 out of 4 in the game from the free throw line.
She is. You know, Thomas also averages 12.3 points per game, and she has 21 three-pointers this season.
So now Christensen with the ball, dribbles into the double team. Underneath to Gale. Gale drives on the right side, covered by Goodwin. Back to Goff. Three-point shot coming. It's up. It's in. Tierra Goff knocks it down.
Tierra Goff's got such a pretty shot, and she made him pay from the arc.
That's a Dairy Farmers America's three-point shot. Thomas splits the defenders over to Wim. Shot up, no good. Rebound taken by Carly Hollingshead, and she'll be fouled.
Carly Hollingshead working really, really hard right there to pull down that board. And one more foul here, and the Lady Beavers will be in the bonus. But Leighton Christian putting on a full-court press.
Second foul on Jada Wims. Cross court, pass up, almost dropped. Christian with it, back to Hollingshead. That was very close to backcourt. And it's Goff. Goff, top of the key. On the left side to Hollingshead. 3:18 left, 14-11, Beavers by three. Cross court pass to Goff. Goff kicks back, going to be pushed. No call again. And the referee's really letting them play. It looks like they went off Abby Yardley, but it's going to stay for the Lady Beavers.
Yeah, and the officials, they really are letting them play on both ends of the floor underneath the basket. I think they're going up thinking they're going to get fouled, and they're not.
Gale back to Christensen, right, left side, three-point jumpers up, no good. Rebound to Tavy Gale for the Beavers. She drives in, kicks back to Goff, and the Lady Beavers will reset. On the right side, Gale, in the middle to Hollingshead. Hollingshead goes up, shot up, no good. Rebound to Goodwin, knocked away by Hollingshead. A steal for Hollingshead, and to Yardley, count it, she's fouled.
Well, you know, Lady Beavers working so hard underneath right there as Carly Hollingshead definitely, you know, overmatched, and she knocks the ball out. Yardley picks it up, puts it back for the and one. That is a huge, huge momentum builder for the Lady Beavers.
Yeah, still Hollingshead offensive rebound for Yardley, and then the putback for the score. That pushes the lead 2-5. Yardley can make it 6 with this Miller County Credit Union free throw. Shot is up and good. She does. And Abby Yardley with 8 points in this second quarter of play pushes the lead to 6 for the Lady Beavers. 2:50 left in the half. Thomas splits the defenders, drives in, fakes. Oh, Abby Yardley moves, and she'll go to the bench with 2 personal fouls. Got to move the feet.
You do, and wow, Thomas is just so quick. I mean, she broke that press like super easy, and Yardley just didn't move and got the foul.
2:44 left. Your score update brought to you by Eagles Landing Scoreboard. Shot is up and good as that moves it back up. Now, Danielle Thomas is making a living at the free throw line. She's got 5 points in the second quarter her own self, and she's 3 out of 3 from the free throw line. Lead is at 5. Lead is up, looks good, and no, it bounces out. Tavy Gale with another defensive rebound. Gale to Hollingshead, covered by Thomas. Cross the timeline. Cross court pass to Goff. Goff looking inside for Nixon, has the bounce pass. Triple team coming. Davis pushes the ball up. Oh, she'll be fouled. Nice job, Davis, forcing the action.
That was a late whistle, but they're going to give the foul to, number 32.
That's Hannah Perry.
Hannah Perry. I didn't know she had checked in the game. So they're giving that to her, and Nixon will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, Goodwin checked out of the game at the last dead ball. Shot up for Davis. No good. And she'll have another one coming. Davis, one of the players of the game last time.
Thomas was trying to cherry pick on the back end there, and that was pretty funny.
Shot is up. Davis misses that one, but Tierra Goff there with the offensive rebound to Christensen. Christensen back in the corner to Goff. Goff fakes a three-point shot out to Hollingshead. And so the lead is 5-22. Hollingshead out to Goff. Goff fakes another three to Christensen, to Gale. Gale drives in, splits the defenders up from eight. Shot no good, though. Rebound can be taken by Perry, and a jump ball called as Gale sneaks in there and stays with the Lady Beavers.
Gale really quick, with her hands, and just reached in there and was able to tie it up to keep the possession.
Christensen on the right wing, covered by Usami. Inside to Davis at the free throw line, out to Goff. And Coach John Marshall will call a play for the Lady Beavers. Oh, knocked away by Thomas, and she'll pick it up with a steal. Covered by Goff, goes up. Goff with a bother, and it's going to go off of two Beavers fighting. Goes out of bounds for Leighton Christian.
I think the Lady Beavers are so terrified. They're going to see the long arms of some of these Leighton Christian girls that come up. They very easy rebound, but just didn't get it.
So with the ball, it will be Henry. Throw inside to Wims. Her shot back up and in. Beautiful setup for Leighton Christian.
Wims, wow, the athleticism of her and Thomas is just, I can't even say enough about it. They're making some really good things happen.
Wims with 6 points. Gale on the right side. Drives, splits the defenders. Minute 38 left. Gale back to Goff. It's the Beavers by three. Hollingshead long three-point jumper is going to go out of bounds. No good. Now, the college three-point line is a little bit longer, and I think that one might have got Carly a little bit.
I agree with you 100%. I think they look down, and if they're behind the orange line, they're going to take it, and that extra however many inches, they can throw your shot way off.
It's about a foot almost. Usami, top of the key to Henry. On the right side to Thomas. Thomas covered by Gale. Takes a screen from Henry. Another screen. Slips the defender. Shot up. No good. Rebound Nixon Davis. Over to Goff. 1:10 left in the half. It's the Beavers by three with the ball. On the right side, Gale slips in. Out to Hollingshead. Hollingshead drives in. Back out to Goff. To Gale. Back to Goff. 58 seconds left in the half. It's 17 Beaver. 14 Leighton Christian. Gale, three-point shot. Right side. No good. And the rebound going to be taken by Perry. 48 seconds left. Thomas with the ball. Covered by Gale, crosses over, splits the defenders. Oh, Nixon Davis gets away with one. And a rebound to Cardi Hollingshead. And she'll get it to Tavy Gale. Gale will dribble up on the left side to Christensen. Lady Beavers might take the last shot of the half. 17-14, 25 seconds left in the half. And the Beavers will spread it out a little. Christensen cross-court pass to Gale. Back to Goff. Now 17 seconds left. Christensen inside to Davis. Davis goes in. She'll be fouled. Count it. She gets the bucket. Beautiful pass from Ja'Coy Christensen to Nixon Davis.
That was about one of the most incredible looks I've seen all season. As they were trying, they had him, Leighton Christensen, they're going to keep it around the perimeter. Christensen sees Davis underneath, fires it in there. Davis gets the and one. What a pretty play.
And that'll earn Davis another spot at the free throw line. And this one's up and in. Nixon Davis knocks down her third point of the quarter. And it's the Beavers by six, matching the biggest of the game. Thomas with it, covered by Gale. Thomas goes on the right side, goes up, and she will travel. A turnover on Leighton Christian, and great defense by the Lady Beavers.
There was two Lady Beavers there that it could have. I almost thought she may call a foul, but it was a turnover.
3 seconds left, over to Gale. Gale at the half splits, goes up at the buzzer, shot up, and takes a couple of bounces, and that'll do it. It's 20-14 at halftime, and that's our score update. Our Eagles Landing scoreboard for Gas, Snacks, Automotive Services, and Champs Chicken. Visit Eagles Landing or High Country Chevron at the I-15 North Interchange in Beaver. We'll take a break. This is the Jones & Mill Engineering Halftime coming up.
For integrity, honesty, and technical expertise, think of Jones and DeMille Engineering. With offices in Richfield, Roosevelt, Price, Manti, Utah Valley, St. George, and Monticello, they're committed to providing their clients with civil and structural engineering, construction management, funding procurement, surveying, GIS mapping, and material testing. They use state-of-the-art equipment to help you meet your budgets, deadlines, and schedules. Visit jonesanddemille.com or find them on Facebook. Since 1982, Jones and DeMille Engineering, your infrastructure professional, shaping the quality of life. Beaver Family Dental is now North Creek Family Dental. You'll see the same staff and receive the same quality care you've come to love. New dentist Boyd Bandy has joined Dr. David Howard to offer a combined 24 years of experience. Whether you need oral cleanings, checkups, dental emergency care, fillings, or crowns, North Creek Family Dental is there for you. They even offer dentures, dental implants, and 24-hour emergency care. North Creek Family Dental is accepting new patients, so call 438-2931.
If you're looking for quality insurance from an agent with a personal touch, call White Insurance in Beaver and Parowan. Joe and Ryan White have over 30 years of experience in the insurance business and understand the needs of local residents and businesses. White Insurance is an independent company which allows them to shop around for the best rates in order to save you money on auto, home, life, health, and business insurance for any size company. Give White Insurance a call today for service with a personal touch. 438-5445. That's 438-5445.
Dairy Farmers of America is a proud supporter of Beaver High School. For the very best in cheese products direct from the factory, visit the chalet at DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver. They carry a nice selection of cheese, including fresh curd, cheddar, Monterey Jack, Swiss, and Colby. Stop in and check out their wide variety of cheese gift boxes and crafts, too. And they offer shipping. Visit their website at dfamilk.com and click on DFA Mart, and then on the picture of the Beaver store. That's DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver.
Welcome back, Scott Lankford, Pepper Gale. It's the Jones and DeMille Engineering halftime. Champions are propelled by dedication, teamwork, commitment, vision, and a desire to be their best. Jones and DeMille Engineering, your local award-winning engineering firm. We appreciate Jones and DeMille sponsoring our halftime. And on the Eagles Landing scoreboard, Champs Chicken and Gas, Automotive Services, Tires, and a whole lot more on North Interchange and Beaver. Our score at halftime, 20-14. If you're joining us late, the Beavers score only 4 points in that first quarter, shooting 9% from the field.
Yeah, one field goal and two free throws, shooting a whopping 9% that first quarter. Leighton Christian, you know, not any better, shooting 8% with a field goal and a free throw. And so both teams are really struggling offensively.
And for it, so as we take a look at just this half of basketball, you know, 27 points in the second quarter as compared to only seven. So at least the second quarter, things started to liven up a little bit.
They did. Both teams come out, you know, got into a more of a rhythm and were able to make some things happen, make some shots fall. You know, both teams actually playing really evenly right now. If you're looking at field goal percentage, Lady Christian or.
We're going to hold off on the stats for just a minute.
Okay.
We're just going to cover the individual scoring real quick. For the Lady Beavers, 4 points. And we've got 8 points. Abby Yardley, 8 points in that second quarter, Pepper.
You know, and Yardley with no points in the first quarter. I think she was maybe a little bit of intimidation there with the height of Goodwin and some of the other girls. But she came out that second quarter and just did phenomenal. And, it, you know, unfortunately, she gets two fouls. But it also had, you know, five offensive rebounds. That's huge.
Yeah, nice job by Yardley. White, no points. Davis with 3 points. 2 points for Carly Hollingshead and Tierra Goff. Now, I got to tell you, we're looking for a Timberline Inn sub of the game. And again, Timberline Inn, you can enjoy tantalizing dishes, great mobile catering, awesome food at Timberline Inn on the North Interchange in Beaver. But we're looking for a sub of the game sponsored by Timberline. It could be Davis, Hollingshead, or Goff. Those three came off the bench and did a great job in that second quarter.
They did. Hollingshead comes in, knocks down the first field goal of the game. Tierra Goff comes in, knocks down the only tray of the game. Davis comes in. She gets a lot of rebounds, gets a and one, gets her 3 points of the game. A lot of fire coming off the bench for the Lady Beavers.
On the Leighton Christian side, we got Jaden Wims and Danielle Thomas leading the way, both with 6 points and 2 points for Tess Henry. But it's really Wims and Thomas, the junior and the sophomore, really keeping Leighton Christian in this game.
They are, and I can't say enough about either one of those girls, just how well they play the game of basketball. They're getting in the passing lanes, they're getting deflections, they're getting steals, they're getting rebounds, they're making things happen. They're doing a great job for Leighton Christian.
It's the Jones and DeMille Engineering halftime. Jones and DeMille Engineering supports our youth in their efforts to develop new talents and passions, paving the way to success. Best of luck to our rural teams this season on the floor as the Beaver High School B-Steps. And Kerry Bradshaw, if you're watching, I kept talking for you. We'll take a break on our Jones Millen Engineering Halftime.
Dairy Farmers of America is a proud supporter of Beaver High School. For the very best in cheese products direct from the factory, visit the chalet at DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver. They carry a nice selection of cheese, including fresh curd, cheddar, Monterey Jack, Swiss, and Colby. Stop in and check out their wide variety of cheese gift boxes and crafts, too. And they offer shipping. Visit their website at dfamilk.com and click on DFA Mart and then on the picture of the Beaver store. That's DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver.
For gas, snacks, and dependable service on your car or truck, visit Eagles Landing, Flying J, and High Country Chevron in Beaver. Mark Yardley and the staff offer convenience items, groceries, fountain drinks, sandwiches, and other goodies. You'll also find a full line of gifts and souvenirs, as well as your favorite gas and oil products. Stop by both locations at the North I-15 interchange in Beaver, High Country Chevron, and Eagles Landing, Flying J. Happy to support Beaver High School sports.
The Beaver Medical Clinic has built a reputation of providing compassionate health care for residents of Beaver and Iron Counties. You'll appreciate the professional services of Drs. B. Noel Robinson, Roger Smith, Wade Oakton, Lance Smith, physician's assistants Reagan Fales, Travis Hicks, and Kenneth Hussey, and nurse practitioners Robin Horton, Lindsay Cheney, Rebecca Rasmussen, and Wade Hollingshead. The Beaver Medical Clinic offers affordable health care and convenient payment options, with offices in Beaver, Milford, and Parowan.
Mike's Food Town in Beaver is proud to serve Beaver County with a wide selection of items at competitive prices. Mike's Food Town is your friendly hometown grocer with the choicest cuts of meat prepared daily. They also go the extra mile to offer the freshest produce on a daily basis. Stop by Mike's Food Town and you'll find out about the super savings in every department. That's Mike's Food Town, located at 270 North Main in Beaver. Happy to support Beaver High School's athletic and academic programs. That's Mike's Food Town.
Service is important on any insurance policy, whether it's auto, home, life, or health insurance. And you can count on your Beaver area Good Neighbor State Farm agent, Brent Stapley, to give you the best service possible. Whether you have a claim or just need information about insurance, your State Farm agent is there with the Good Neighbor service we're famous for. See State Farm agent Brent Stapley in Beaver for all your insurance needs. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call 438-5451, 438-5451.
Welcome back. It's the Jones and DeMille Engineering Halftime, and Jones and DeMille Engineering sponsors local programs supporting academic and athletic achievements. Building lasting relationships and working passionately is a winning combination. Jones and DeMille Engineering. So 20-14, it's the Lady Beavers on top. Let's take a look at some team stats as we took a look at our stat check sponsored by
State Farm
Insurance. Brent Stapley's my agent. If you're stuck in a state of falling behind with kids' financial insurance, talk to Brent Stapley. Now, we talked about 8-9% as our field goal percentage, a dismal first quarter. Tell me what happened in quarter number two.
Both teams decided to come alive and make a couple of field goals. And the Lady Beavers, dramatically increasing their field goal percentage, going from 9% to 22%, and likewise, 9% to 23%, and likewise, Leighton Christian going from 8% to 22%. So both teams coming out and putting some points on the board.
Those of you who are watching on Local10.tv, you can see the highlights of the first half. And we want to give a big shout out to Centricom, Local 10, and Barrett and the crew up there running the computer. We do appreciate them. They do an awesome job. They've taken care of us all season long on the Beaver Sports Network, Mid-Utah Sports Radio Sports Network, and then Local 10, Centricom Channel 10. Appreciate all of our people who bring you these broadcasts. And glad to have you along. So it's 20-14 as we take a look at the start of the second half, sponsored by Beaver Drug and Gift. Pepper, first of all, the keys to the second half for the Lady Beavers.
For the Lady Beavers, they've got to pull down some offensive rebounds and putbacks. And they've also, the key to the game right here, I think, for both teams is scoring. The Lady Beavers have got to put the ball through the hoop, and they've got to get a basket.
Now for Leighton Christian, I believe it's got to be Kylie Goodwin in the middle. They've got a girl who's 6'4", and she hasn't had any point-blank looks at the baskets, and she is scoreless in this first half.
Credit Yardley and Davis for the defense on her, because with her height, you would expect her to have a bunch of points. But they've shut her down, and it's been Thomas and Wims, who have carried this team.
That's your Beaver Drug and Gift start of the second half, Keys. And for full service pharmacy, gifts, cards, medical equipment, and diabetic supplies, visit Beaver Drug and Gift at 98 North Main in Beaver. We're ready for the start of third quarter action here from the Sevier Valley Center. Just got a text that it's snowing like crazy, so everyone who drives home needs to do so very, very carefully. Thomas with the ball. Leighton Christian will start the third quarter of play, 7:52. As Thomas drives in, and she's going to run into some traffic, goes off of Leighton Christian. Good defense by the Lady Beavers.
I was expecting to have a foul there, but it was not.
I would not have been surprised to hear a whistle, as it looked like there was a lot of contact. Christian inside the yardy drop, though, and picked up by Lusk. Now Leighton Christian comes back. It's Thomas. Danielle with the ball. Top of the key covered by Gale. 7:32, just underway in third quarter action. Thomas crosses over on the left side to Lusk. Inside to Goodwin. It looks like Leighton Christian, triple teamed. It's going to be knocked down, picked up by Carter. Team steal. Carter on the left side with the left hand underneath to Jillens. Jillens on the left side where she likes it. Shot up, no good. But there's Abby Yardley with an offensive rebound. No good. Wims takes down the board. And Leighton Christian on the run. Thomas quickly ahead to Lusk. Lusk fouled by Carter. Will go to the free throw line.
Lady Beavers had two opportunities right there to get the first two points of the half, but neither Jillens or Yardley were able to capitalize. Lusk, on the other hand, drives down the floor, picks up a foul on Carter, and she'll go to the free throw line.
You can see that Leighton Christian would like to be more aggressive in this second half. Lusk free throw up and in. So Leighton Christian scores first in the third quarter of play, and that is a free throw sponsored by Miller County Credit Union. Again, for low interest rates on auto and RV loans, mobile banking coming soon. That's Miller County Credit Union. Rebound to Christensen. She'll bring it up. 7 minutes left. It's a 5-point lead for the Lady Beavers, trying to get into semifinal action facing the winner of Emory and Enterprise. Already, North Sevier and North Summit have notched their tickets into the title game.
North Summit and Kanab.
How about Abby Yardley underneath? Tell us what happened.
That was just a fantastic entry play, entry pass into Yardley. Yardley not letting the height of Goodwin get to her as she calmly just pivoted into the basket, kissed it off the glass, and got 2 points.
Beautifully said. 10 points for Yardley. Double teamed. Almost a 5-second call. She dribbled the ball. That's actually a turnover.
Yes, it should have been.
But the referees missed it. Inside to Goodwin. Stolen away by Jillens. And Yardley with it. And they're going to call it jump ball. It will go to the Beaver High School Beavers.
You know, credit both Yardley and Jillens with the defense right there. Jillens falling hard to the floor and them tying it up, but they maintain possession.
Full court press by Leighton Christian. Carter ahead. Thomas chasing from behind. Carter up from 8 feet. And Britland Carter knocks one down. Off balance jumper goes down. Biggest lead of the game now, 9.
Took a shooter's bounce and great shot right over Goodwin.
Thomas with it, covered by Gale. 6 left in the third. 24-15. Gale knocks away from Thomas. She picks it up. It's going to be a foot race. Gale and Thomas. Gale's going to go up under pressure. She scores it. The Pink Panther strikes again.
And Thomas was Pink Panthered as Gale got the steal and the layup. And the momentum is all the way for the Lady Beavers.
Timeout will take it. 26-15. 11-point lead for the Lady Beavers. We'll be back.
Beaver Valley Chevron and Dairy Queen team up to keep you and your vehicle running smoothly. Beaver Valley Chevron is a 24-hour AAA towing service and repair facility with top-quality Chevron gas. You'll also appreciate their modern restrooms, Eager Beaver Touchless Car Wash that offers the newest in car wash technology, and now featuring Orange Julius and smoothies. And of course, stop in Dairy Queen anytime for a variety of meal deals and irresistible ice cream treats. Visit Beaver Valley Chevron and Dairy Queen at the I-15 South exit in Beaver.
Our emphasis has always been on first-name friendly service with a hometown touch. We know you, and you know us. Hometown people helping each other grow. We're here to serve all your banking needs. Utah Independent Bank, member FDIC. Hometown people, hometown spirit.
Time out by the Leighton Christian Eagles was very, very necessary as they're down by 11. And that's a Fish Lake Lumber timeout. Appreciate Lynn Anderson, the gang at Fish Lake Lumber. So it's 11-point lead. Full court press remains for the Beavers. Lusk with the ball. Crosses the timeline. A near steal, but Leighton Christian able to make those passes. Thomas with it on the right wing. T- Top of the key to Lusk. Excuse me, that's Henry. Now to Lusk on the left wing. Just under 6 minutes left. Tavy Gale almost with a steal. As back to Thomas. To Henry. Back to Lusk. Inside to Goodwin. Goodwin turns and faces. Back to Henry, covered by Christensen. Lady Beavers defense. Pretty close. Good patience by Leighton Christian. Thomas drives. Excuse me, to Lusk. Lusk, 14-foot jumpers up, and no good. Rebound, Abby Yardley, and now a foul to Lusk.
Wow, Lusk, you know, that just it just bounced in and out. A little bit of frustration foul, I think, as Yardley pulled the rebound down. That'll be Lusk's third foul.
Yeah, good hustle. A little frustration for Lusk as she tries to get that back. That ball was almost in, and as you mentioned, rimmed out. So a little frustration as Whitney picks up foul number three. Looks like a quick substitution in for her. Christensen left side. It's the Beavers by 11, 26-15. 5:13 left in the first half. Sydney Jones with the ball, looking for Christensen. Hazard outside the timeline. Christian drives on the left side. Oh, foul to Lusk. Now that's number four. Big time trouble for the senior guard for Leighton Christian.
And that's frustrating, you know, for Coach Schrader, as he's got a sub in coming in for her, picks up her fourth foul. I don't think we'll be seeing Lusk until anytime, you know, deep in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, I like the coaching staff. They just kind of congratulated Whitney Lusk. And now Jillian shot, bothered by Goodwin. Rebound almost by Gale. Nope. Gale gets it back, puts it up and in. Tavy Gale for two more.
Gale was kind of in the right place at the right time right there as she gets a hand on the ball and was able to get the putback.
8-1 run by the Lady Beavers in the third. Now Sydney Jillian with a steal. The ball's loose on the floor, and there's Thomas, and she'll pick it up. Nope. Jump ball called, and it stays to Leighton Christian. The Beaver defense has stepped it up in this third quarter.
Credit the hustle by Jill. She did not give up. She got a hand on it. She kept going after it. Was able to get the jump ball call. Great hustle by Jones.
Thomas with the ball, covered by Gale. Left side now to Henry. Henry covered by Christensen. Back to Thomas. 4:32 left. It's the Beavers by 13. The winner faces the winner of Emory and Enterprise in semifinal action. Inside it's Wims. Shot up and good for Goodwin. And that's what we expected a lot of. First points of the game for Kylie Goodwin.
You know, and Yardley did exactly what she could right there. She stood straight up, didn't jump, didn't draw the foul. She played it just exactly right, but the ball was able to fall.
And now Jillian's three-point jumper's up. No good. Rebound, Abby Yardley. Another offensive board to Christensen. Good shot blocked by Wims. Offensive rebound for Ja'Coy Christensen to Gale. Gale drives around. Goodwin shot blocked by Wims. And Leighton Christian's Goodwin with the rebound.
That was awesome. For Wims, that was incredible.
And on the left side, Henry. Wow, that's an NBA three. And Abby O is going to be Tavy Gale with the board on the right side. She pushes the action. Drives over now. Stolen away by Henry. She's ahead of the pack. Carter trying to catch up. And it'll go in. As a nice steal by number 22, Tess Henry. Not Lusk. My bad.
No, that was a great steal. She just took it coast to coast. Got the points on the board for the Lady Eagles.
Gale on the right side. Back to Carter. Carter to Carter. Now to Christensen, rather. 3:18 left in the third. It's a 9-point lead for the Lady Beavers. On the baseline to Yardley. Yardley's jump shot up, no good. And the rebound going to be taken by Ja'Coy Christensen. She goes up, no good. Rebound to Abby Yardley. Shot up, no good. Rebound finally to Kylie Goodwin. A rebounding machine are these Lady Beavers.
They are, and unfortunately that time, three opportunities were not able to capitalize.
Thomas on the left side to Henry. Henry top key to Usami. On the right side to Thomas, back to Henry. Usami on the left wing now. And Lady Eagles trying to find some space. Henry deep on the right wing. She wants to take Christian on the drive. Can drive around, pushed a little bit, forces up a shot, no good. Wims with an offensive board, back to Henry. Henry double drives, picks up, and I think Tavy Gale picks up foul number two.
Lady Beavers, I think you can see they're getting a little bit fatigued. They're not going after the ball quite as hard. I can hear Coach Marshall yelling at them to rebound, and, you know, Gale getting her second foul.
Substitutions galore coming at the break. 2:25 left in the third. It's a 9-point lead. This could cut it to seven. First free throws in the game for Tess Henry. Shot is up and in. Tess knocks down her fifth point with the free throw. And in the game comes a whole new team for the Lady Beavers. Only Jillian stays in the game. So 40 Davis, 22, Captain Chaos White, Tierra Goff, and Cardi Hollingshead. And Goodwin out for the Eagles. Replaced. Trying to get a number out here. Can't see who replaced her. We'll get it in a minute. Number four, that's Miranda Soto. Shot is up, no good. Nixon Davis with the rebound over to Goff. Again, Lady Beavers by eight, 2:21 left in the third. Goff over to Hollingshead. Hollingshead steps back and gets it back to Goff. She'll reset the offense at the 2:13 mark. Beavers by eight. Pass knocked down away by Henry. Now Henry's got some long arms and quick reflexes as well.
She does too, and we've seen her be able to shoot inside and outside. So for her height, you know, she's a threat everywhere offensively on the floor.
Inside ball knocked away. There's Lindley White. Shot up, no good. Offensive rebound for Nixon Davis. Davis back to White. White drives down the left side. Oh, she'll be fouled by Henry. And great sportsmanship by Tess as she helps pick up Captain Chaos. She'll go to the line and shoot two.
You know, and Tess Henry, she just saw White coming over in the lane, and she just tried to move over. White had nothing but momentum behind her. She wasn't stopping, but Henry getting the block. But like you said, great sportsmanship immediately helped her up.
So Lindley White with the ball on the free throw line, shooting two. Her first free throws of the game. White's first free throw's up and good. As Lindley White knocks down free throw number one. She hits her first point of the game. 2 minutes left in this one. Just a reminder, we're looking for a stop of the game. The Tony Dave's Auto Center. That might have been one of the crashes of the game as Henry threw the hip into White. And if you get your car crashed like Henry crashed into White, you can get it fixed at Tony and Dave's, an I-class gold facility. 1:53 left in this third. It's a 9-point lead, 29-20 on the right side, Thomas with the ball. Thomas drives in, cut off by Jones. Good help by the Lady Beavers. Usami to Henry. Henry, 14-foot jumper up short, no good. Rebound going to be taken by White, and she'll get it to Davis. Now the Lady Beavers with the ball, moving ahead. It's Goff with a left-hand dribble, covered by Usami, and now Thomas. Goes to the right side. Goff reverses over to Jones. Timeout. We'll take it as well and be back after this.
Since 1947, Barney Trucking in Salina has built a reputation of unparalleled customer service and satisfaction in the trucking industry. Barney Trucking in Salina is now hiring local drivers. If you're looking for a solid career in the trucking industry that has a positive working environment, join the big blue trucks of Barney Trucking. The job includes benefits, training, retirement, and requires a Class A CDL license and an endorsement for doubles and triples. To apply, go to BarneyTrucking.com or call 529-4422. That's 529-4422.
Welcome back, Scott Langford, Pepper Gale. Let's take a look at our South Creek Shell leading scorers, offering everything from Burger King to gas and snacks, over 1,200 tires in stock. South Creek Shell, South Interchange in Beaver. And right now for the Lady Beavers, it's 10 points for Abby Ardley, 8 points for Tavy Gale. And now for Leighton Christian, it still is 6 points for Jada Wims and Danielle Thomas. Both scoreless in the third quarter. Now Gale all by herself, left side, shot up and in. Gillens, rather, with the bucket.
That was a great, I think they caught Leighton Christian unaware right there.
Back to 11. Thomas with the ball, top of the key. A minute 16 left in the third. Over to Usami. Usami drives with the left hand. Cut off by Goff. Back top of the key. This is Soto. And Soto back on the right side to Wims. Underneath Usami. And the ball's going to be knocked away, picked up by Davis. And a turnover on the Lady Eagles. 55 seconds left in the third. Lady Beavers by 11. Hollingshead drives in, steps back out. She was wide open, chose not to take the shot. 47 seconds left. Jones on the left side, baseline to White. White will dribble out and get it back, top of the key to Goff. 40 seconds left, and Coach John Marshall says one shot. Beavers will try to run the clock down. Back to White. White, top of the key, dribbles back out. And she looks over for Goff, having a hard time finding someone. And now finds Tierra. 22 seconds left. It's 31-20. Lady Beavers on top, and a travel on the Lady Beavers. Turnover goes to Leighton Christian at the end of three.
That's unfortunate for the Lady Beavers as they have 18 seconds trying to get the last bucket of the quarter. But, you know, they just have to come out and play some tough defense.
Usami with the ball. 15 seconds left. Thomas with the ball. 10 seconds now. Leighton Christian sets. Thomas with an isolation. Crosses over, uses her speed. Oh, she should have picked up a foul as well, but she knocks down a bucket at the end of three quarters. Goff throws it. Three quarters court. No good. And it's a 9-point lead by the Lady Beavers going into the fourth quarter when we come back.
For a full-service pharmacy, gifts, cards, medical equipment, and diabetic supplies, visit Beaver Drug and Gift at 98 North Main in Beaver.
Beaver Drug and Gift features a full-service pharmacy, offers a wide variety of medical equipment and diabetic supplies. They're also stocked with a wide variety of items, including gift cards, a wide range of gifts, and treats. Enjoy their friendly service, everyday savings, and expert advice from their knowledgeable pharmacists. That's Beaver Drug and Gift in Beaver. Tired of the hassle of keeping the books of your business? If so, call Majestic Financial Services, a trusted accounting firm that provides payroll, income tax preparation, and bookkeeping services. For businesses or individuals, call 438-7777. For expert advice and service in the real estate sector, there is no one more qualified than broker Gary Brown of Coldwell Banker Advantage Realty in Beaver, who specializes in marketing your property or finding residential, commercial, or recreational properties. Call 438-7777.
Welcome back. Three down, one to go. 31-22. It's a 9-point lead for the Lady Beavers, trying to get into semifinal action against the winner of Emory and Enterprise. Scott Lankford, Pepper Gale. And Pepper, talk to me a little about stats real quick as we go into fourth quarter action. And then I'll tell you who the players are.
Leighton Christian shooting 26%, Lady Beavers 27. Offensive rebounds, never mind.
Gale on the baseline inside. DiArdi. DiArdi shot up, no good. She was fouled, no call. And then the Lady, oh. So Gale might have fouled her. It went off of Leighton Christian, might have all balanced out.
That works out great for the Lady Beavers.
So for Leighton Christian, it's going to be Thomas Usami, 22, Henry, number two. Oh, number four is actually Soto. And now Thomas drives in, and she scores it. She just splits the defenders. She's fast.
She is, and you can see that as soon as she starts driving, they just clear the lane.
Gale on the right side, shot up, no good. Rebound going to be taken by Soto. That's Usami, rather. Ahead to Thomas. Thomas goes up. She'll travel, and it goes back to the Lady Beavers.
That was fortunate for the Lady Beavers because that would have cut the lead. And Carter checks in for the Lady Beavers as well as Christensen.
7:29 left in this game, and it's a 2-0 run by Leighton Christian to start this fourth quarter. White to Carter. Carter dribbles out of traffic. She's covered by Thomas. Crosses over. Now Usami comes over to Christensen. Covered by Henry. Christensen will drive and kick it over to Gale. Gale on the right wing. 7:16 left. Gale. Cross-court pass to Christensen, looking inside for Yardley. Has her, can't throw it. Back to Carter to Gale. Gale will drive back to Christensen, to Carter. Carter will drive on the left side, layup up, no good. Rebound though to Abby Yardley. She gets over to Tavy Gale to Christensen. Christensen, two-point jumpers up and in. Ja'Coy Christensen knocks down her first bucket of the game.
That was huge. Lady Beavers needed a stop right there. They needed to try to keep that lead, you know, within nine, and Christensen does it.
And for Leighton Christian, they're trying to chip away. Nine is as close as they've been for about a half of a quarter. So it's 33-24 Beaver, 6:40 left in the game. On the left side, Henry, three-point jumpers up and no good. Rebound to be taken by Abby Yardley. She's been a monster on the boards. Carter back on underneath to White. White drives up. Henry, no call. Wims with the rebound. And a lot of contact, no call. Thomas with it, goes up over Carter. Carter makes sure she fouls. And it'll be Thomas to the free throw line.
No, Danielle Thomas. You just watch her. She is not giving up. She is working so hard on both ends of the floor. And she's doing extremely well from the free throw line as well. 4 for 6.
Just a reminder, we're looking for a Coldwell Banker play of the game for expert real estate and financial advice. Call Gary Brown at Coldwell Banker Advantage Realty and Majestic Financial Services. First free throw missed by Thomas. And that's three fouls on Britland Carter. And Lindley White will check out. Carter stays in the game. Shot is up. This one is good. Only 6 out of 12 in the game for Leighton Christian. And now it's going to be Christian with the ball. Over to Yardley. Yardley on the right side to Gale. And they reset the offense. Gale, oh, travels. They got called. A little bit of a carry. Goes back to Leighton Christian. 8-point lead. And Leighton Christian with the ball.
Lady Beavers trying to, you know, get back in the sink. The sink they had the third quarter, as they played extremely well that third quarter. A little bit of struggle the first couple of minutes this quarter.
With the ball on the right side, it's going to be Soto. Soto, top of the key to Usami. Over to Henry. Henry fakes, drives hard on Yardley. Yardley just jumps into Henry, and that's going to be on the ground. So it'll be the third foul for Abby Yardley. And they'll be on the baseline for Leighton Christian. 14 fouls for the Beavers, 3 for Leighton Christian.
Now both teams with still a few fouls to give.
Usami on the baseline. Looking for Thomas. Has Thomas on the baseline, covered by Gale. Drives in, kicks back out. Long three-point jumper coming. That one looks good, but it bounces off. Rebound going to be to Britland Carter. And she'll take the screen from Gale across the timeline. Thomas goes on the right side, cuts off Carter, back to Jillins at the free throw line. Jillins fakes, goes on the left side, shot up, and Sydney Jillins with a patented left hand. And Coach John Marshall takes a timeout. We'll take it as well. Beavers by 10 when we come back.
Your Carl's Jr. and Beaver and Fillmore not only specializes in delicious charbroiled burgers, they're heavily involved in supporting local area events. The owners and management care about the community and have lent their support to the PTA Walkathon, library reading and local schools programs, the National ATV Jamboree, Swim Fest. They've raised over $11,000 in juvenile diabetes research, and they're currently raising money to support our troops and their Stars for Heroes program. Your local Carl's Jr. and Beaver and Fillmore, not just a local burger joint, a contributor to your community. For integrity, honesty, and technical expertise, think of Jones & DeMille Engineering. With offices in Richfield, Roosevelt, Price, Manti, Utah Valley, St. George, and Monticello, they're committed to providing their clients with civil and structural engineering, construction management, funding procurement, surveying, GIS mapping, and material testing. They use state-of-the-art equipment to help you meet your budgets, deadlines, and schedules. Visit jonesanddemille.com or find them on Facebook. Since 1982, Jones & DeMille Engineering, your infrastructure professional, shaping the quality of life.
Welcome back, Scott Langford, Pepper Gale. 5:35 left in this one. The winner goes on to take the winner of Emory and Enterprise. Earlier in action, it's North Sevier defeating North Summit, and then Kanab easily defeating
San Juan.
San Juan, that's right. So Thomas with the ball, and she'll come across the timeline. 5:31 left in the game. She's covered by Gale on the right side to Soto, on the right side to Thomas. Thomas takes the screen, kicks back up top. Now to number 15, Mitt Wims. Wims shot up, no good. Rebound, Tavy Gale for the Lady Beavers, and the Beavers on the run. Gale brings it across the timeline back to Carter. 10-point lead for the Beavers to Christensen. Christensen on the left side now has it to Yardi. Yardi can pivot. She'll turn around. Wims with the foul. That's her third personal.
Yeah, Wims, she was all over Yardley. Christensen had the entry pass before she actually gave it, but worked out well as they drew the foul on somebody.
Inside, Jillins from Gale. Shot up and in. Sydney Jillins on that left side is deadly and continues to be so. That pushes the lead to 12, biggest lead since 13 in the third quarter. Now it's out to Henry. We haven't seen a lot of Kylie Goodwin, the star center for Leighton Christian, in this fourth quarter. Thomas with a beautiful crossover. Out to Soto on the right side, now to Henry. A lot of contact, no call. Henry takes a 14-foot jumper up, no good. Abby Yardley skies for the rebound, and the Lady Beavers have it with a 12-point lead. Carter comes across, over to Christensen. Christensen covered by Henry. Christensen will take her time out to Carter. Carter drives with the right hand, drives out, takes a shot from the right side, no good. Wims with the rebound, and it's going to go back to Henry. 4:19 left in the game, 12-point lead for Beaver. Leighton Christian, oh, had a player. Lusk back in the game. Couldn't quite get it there. And there'll be a timeout on the floor. We'll take it as well. 4 minutes left in this one. It's the Beavers by 12.
Beaver Family Dental is now North Creek Family Dental. You'll see the same staff and receive the same quality care you've come to love. New dentist Boyd Bandy has joined Dr. David Howard to offer a combined 24 years of experience. Whether you need oral cleanings, checkups, dental emergency care, fillings, or crowns, North Creek Family Dental is there for you. They even offer dentures, dental implants, and 24-hour emergency care. North Creek Family Dental is accepting new patients, so call 438-2931.
If you're looking for quality insurance from an agent with a personal touch, call White Insurance in Beaver and Parowan. Joe and Ryan White have over 30 years of experience in the insurance business and understand the needs of local residents and businesses. White Insurance is an independent company which allows them to shop around for the best rates in order to save you money on auto, home, life, health, and business insurance for any size company. Give White Insurance a call today for service with a personal touch. 438-5445. That's 438-5445.
Lady Beavers up by 12, trying to notch a place in the semifinal game tomorrow night against either Emory or Enterprise. Just a reminder, we're looking for some players of the game, a Dairy Queen defensive player of the game, and AAA towing and great food, Beaver Valley Chevron, Dairy Queen, South Interchange, and a Mike's Food Town player of the game. And winner of DiGiorno Pizza. Great food, a bakery, and more. Beavers back in action. Jump ball called. It'll go back to Leighton Christian. Turnover on the Lady Beavers.
Gail trying to strip it after it was stolen away underneath. Tied it up, so back to Leighton Christian.
4 minutes left in this basketball game. It's Beavers by 12. Leighton Christian has to score quickly. Luskin knocked away. Tavy Gale with the steal. And the Lady Beavers on the run. Gale on the right side, covered by Thomas. Crossover. Gale goes up in traffic. Shot up and in. Tavy Gale, the menace continues.
She keeps giving the Pink Panther treatment to Leighton Christian, getting her 10th point of the game.
Oh, Wims with an offensive foul. Leads on an elbow as Nixon Davis with a nice defensive move. Hey, I've got a new nickname for Tavy Gale.
What's that?
The Phantom Menace.
The Phantom Menace. That's a good one.
Yeah. Not too bad.
Now, you keep calling 15 Whims. I believe 15 may be Danielle England. I am wrong.
I've got Jada Whim. I got Whims.
Okay, then don't listen to me.
Let me look at the thing to make sure.
You are correct.
All right,
I am
then
wrong.
Nixon Davis inside. Beautiful pass. Davis scores the Beavers now by 16 points. Biggest lead of the game.
They need to keep the pressure on with 3 minutes left in the game. They still have to keep, they have to keep scoring.
So it's going to be Thomas, top of the key, over to Usami. Back top of the key to Soto. Soto on the left side to Usami. Drives baseline, nice move. Goes up in traffic, shot up. Oh, no good. Wims with the rebound. Shot up, no good. Lusk with the rebound. Shot up, no good. Rebound finally to Britland Carter for the Beavers. And Wims turns an ankle. She's still down. We'll keep an eye on her. Britland Carter back with the action and a timeout quick. And Pepper, it's the break for the Lady Beavers.
It is. Lady Beavers are really taking it away right now. It's unfortunate for Leighton Christian as Wims, turning her ankle. And now we're going to see the reappearance of Kylie Goodwin.
Yeah, Kylie Goodwin back in. And hopefully Jada's okay. She's played a phenomenal game. I thought she's been great.
She has, and I hate to see anybody get an injury, especially during state tournament time. These girls have worked so hard to get here, and we do not want to see anybody get hurt.
The lead is up to 18 now for the Lady Beavers with 2:37 left. Substitutions coming. Soto looking inside for Lusk. Lusk drives in. Right-hand bucket up, no good. Rebound taken by Nixon Davis, and she gets it to Tavy Gale. Foul on Leighton Christian. It goes to the Beavers, and there's going to be a lot of substitutions coming in.
There is that foul. I'm not sure who it's called on.
It's going to be on number two.
Number two.
Yeah.
That's her first foul of the game, I believe.
Usami with the foul. And now all the Beavers come out except for Nixon Davis. And they get a big hand, the starting four that are still in the game as they've got an 18-point lead. 2:27 left. The Lady Beavers likely to move on. Lindley White in the game. She'll cross the timeline. Back over to Goff. Goff, top of the key. She'll hand off to Hollingshead. Thomas on Hollingshead. Now Thomas with a body foul. And it will be a 1-1 for Carly Hollingshead.
Danielle Thomas picking up her first foul of the game. And, you know, Thomas, I just got to tell you, I keep talking about her throughout this game, but she's everywhere. She's causing deflections. She's getting rebounds. She's playing just a phenomenal game.
Hollingshead knocks down free throw number one. She'll earn another. And I agree, Thomas, we'll see her for another 2 years. She's a phenomenal talent.
Yeah, only a sophomore.
For Leighton Christian. Shot is up. That one's no good. Rebound to Soto. Soto for Leighton Christian. And Thomas back with the ball. 2 minutes left in this basketball game, and the lead goes to 19. Underneath, Goodwin. Goodwin with the right-hand baby hook. Shot up, no good. Rebound to Cardi Hollingshead. Hollingshead will turn. And drive on the right side. Thomas shadowing her on the baseline to Davis. Davis drives, kicks back up to Goff. And the Lady Beavers will step back out. Over to Robinson. Braley with the ball. And she'll get it over to Cardi Hollingshead. Hollingshead drives on the right side. Back over to Goff. Minute 37 left in the game. Hollingshead, double team, now dribbles out. Back over to Robinson. Robinson holds the ball. Covered by Soto. Top of the key now to Goff. And the Beavers hold, 1:24 left. Goff reverses dribble. Close to a 5 second call, but gets over to White. And Lady Beavers continue to draw some clock. White goes in, loses the ball. And it's gonna go to Leighton Christian as the ball's moved by Lusk. Lusk quickly ahead of the pack. She'll go all the way to Thomas on the right side. Thomas goes in and a foul to Lindley White. And get ready on the iPad. Lots of substitutions coming. And only 14 fouls. That's only the fifth on the Beavers. So for Leighton Christian, 34, 55, and 23 will be in the game. And I'll tell you the other three. Staying in the game is number 20 and number 4 for Leighton Christian. For the Beavers, Emily Lankford comes in the game along with Emma Robinson and Taylin Brown. Top of the key, Thomas. A minute left. Thomas long, three-point jumper's up. No good. Rebound to Brown. Taylin with the ball. 55 seconds left. Brown dribbles back out to Goff. Goff, top of the key. They'll call a play. 48 seconds left in the game. The Beavers moving on with a big win. Goff up and blocked away by Soto. And it'll go to the Lady Beavers on the baseline. 42.9 left.
What an awesome block was that. That was just great. Just had her hand right on it and just says, no, I'm not going to let you do that.
Emma Robinson with the ball for the Lady Beavers. Underneath to Goff. Goff will kick back out to Robinson. Robinson covered by Thomas. Robinson loses the ball. Oh, no, she gets it back to Robinson. Emma. Emma Taylin to Goff. Tierra with it. On the left side, back to Robinson. 28 seconds left in the game. Braylee Robinson inside to Lankford. Lankford fakes. Kicks back up to Robinson. Stolen away almost by Thomas, but it stays for the Lady Beavers. 20.8 left in the game. Just a reminder, we're going to have some quick stats and more on the Sunrise Engineering postgame. Sunrise Engineering promoting athletic and academic excellence. Emma Robinson with the ball to Robinson. Robinson, 8 foot. Jumper up. No good. Rebound taken by Soto, and it's a foul to Taylin Brown. Goes to the summit to Leighton Christian, rather.
So you mentioned that number 23 for Leighton Christian checked into the game. I'd like to pronounce her name for us.
All right, hold on, I've got this. Ryua Mirira.
I don't think that's
She's
it.
She's from Uganda, and I had a nice talk with her, but we call her Orla R. Emma Robinson goes up on the left side. Oh, stolen away by Soto, and a jump ball call. They'll let it run out. And the Lady Beavers notch their bid for the championship game. Well, championship bracket with a 44-25 win as they hold Leighton Christian only 3 points in that fourth quarter.
That's just some great defense as the Lady Beavers worked really, really hard, you know, to come up with a, after, you know, three quarters only up by 10 to cap off this game to win by 19.
All right, we'll take a break. It's a Sunrise Engineering postgame promoting athletic and academic excellence. Visit them at sunrise-eng.com. We'll take a break and be back after these messages.
Dairy Farmers of America is a proud supporter of Beaver High School. For the very best of cheese products direct from the factory, visit the chalet at DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver. They carry a nice selection of cheese, including fresh curd, cheddar, Monterey Jack, Swiss, and Colby. Stop in and check out their wide variety of cheese gift boxes and crafts, too. And they offer shipping. Visit their website at dfamilk.com and click on DFA Mart and then on the picture of the Beaver store. That's DFA Cache Valley Cheese in Beaver.
For gas, snacks, and dependable service on your car or truck, visit Eagles Landing, Flying J, and High Country Chevron in Beaver. Mark Yardley and the staff offer convenience items, groceries, fountain drinks, sandwiches, and other goodies. You'll also find a full line of gifts and souvenirs, as well as your favorite gas and oil products. Stop by both locations at the North I-15 interchange in Beaver, High Country Chevron, and Eagles Landing, Flying J. Happy to support Beaver High School sports.
The Beaver Medical Clinic has built a reputation of providing compassionate health care for residents of Beaver and Iron Counties. You'll appreciate the professional services of Drs. B. Noel Robinson, Roger Smith, Wade Oakden, Lance Smith, Physicians Assistants Reagan Fales, Travis Hicks, and Kenneth Hussey, and Nurse Practitioners Robin Horton, Lindsay Cheney, Rebecca Rasmussen, and Wade Hollingshead. The Beaver Medical Clinic offers affordable health care and convenient payment options, with offices in Beaver, Milford, and Parowan.
Mike's Food Town in Beaver is proud to serve Beaver County with a wide selection of items at competitive prices. Mike's Food Town is your friendly hometown grocer with the choicest cuts of meat prepared daily. They also go the extra mile to offer the freshest produce on a daily basis. Stop by Mike's Food Town and you'll find out about the super savings in every department. That's Mike's Food Town, located at 270 North Main in Beaver. Happy to support Beaver High School's athletic and academic programs. That's Mike's Food Town.
Give it to Carter.
Welcome back. Scott Lankford, Pepper Gale on the Sunrise Engineering postgame. Sunrise Engineer working every day to make things better. That's Sunrise Engineering. You can check them out at sunrise-eng.com. So it's a final. The Lady Beavers defeat Leighton Christian and that's 44-25. And Pepper, really a 19-point win. It was kind of close in that first quarter, but the Lady Beavers defense really came through.
It did. The Lady Beavers working really hard on defense. You know, they had 12 steals. They had 16 offensive rebounds, 26 defensive rebounds. And that's in opposition to 4 steals from Leighton Christian, 10 offensive rebounds, and 18 defensive rebounds. So that second half, they stepped it up. At the half, it was about – both teams were playing about evenly. But the second half, Lady Beavers really came out and played hard.
Now let's take a look at some of our plays of the game. Coldwell Banker play of the game for Expert Real Estate and Accounting Services. Call Gary Brown, 438-7777. That's 438-7777. And the play of the game goes to the Phantom Menace, the Pink Panther, as she steals it from Thomas and goes coast-to-coast with some pressure. And that will be the Coldwell Banker play of the game. We take a look at some of the other ones. The stop of the game for Tony Dave's Auto Center, stop of the game. I'm going to give that one to Henry as she threw that hip out and took out Lindley White. And, you know, for a place that does such a great job with car collisions and repairing your vehicle, I think that collision was, I'm going to call it the Tony and Dave's Auto Center collision of the game.
It was, and the best thing about that was it was not intentional. She was just trying to get in the way and stop the ball. And then immediately after White hit the floor, she reached down and picked her back up. I love to see that in sports.
Yeah, our Timberline Inn sub of the game. Enjoy Tantalizing Dishes from Timberline Inn. And now we'll go to Carly Hollingshead as she has 3 points.